Hello and welcome to the final episode of Speed Model Season 2. Essentially, we've come to a point where we are almost ready to render, but I felt the room still looked a little bit empty. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through again and just add some more little details. And once we're done with that, well, we're gonna actually call it a day and render everything out. So ladies and gentlemen, you're watching episode 8 of Speed Model. One of the first major changes to be made to really lock in the realism of the room is some ceiling lights. I split the ceiling into its own mesh and begin to set up the lights. To have the lights cut into the roof mesh, I use a system of Boolean operations. I simply have to position the lights correctly, and Blender helps me merge them into the roof mesh. After some further adjustments, I go ahead to space the cylinders out across the roof mesh. This one is also a little tricky, since we do have to think about how far apart the lights are spaced out, and how many we want in total. You can see me trying out a variety of configurations, all of which I wasn't entirely comfortable with. Eventually, however, I settle for a ring of 10 lamps. Then, I add a little mesh that will act as a diffuser for the lamp. It's just a simple cylinder with subdivision, giving it a nice curved shape. I position it nicely into the opening of the light. Then, I add a second cylinder, which will act as a reflector, those little silvery things you see in lamps to amplify the light. I wanted to see if I could cut corners by simply letting the diffuser be emissive, but it didn't really look great. So I added a new sphere to act as a light source above the diffuser. As you can see, the effect is far more realistic. To take it a step further, I also stretch out the sphere. I tweak around with the materials a bit, but eventually remain very close to the original color. After some thought, I replace the subdivided diffuser with a simple conical surface. As you can see, it looks the same, but has less faces, which I hoped would optimize the rendering slightly. You can see me now experimenting with both the materials and the positioning of the various elements. Eventually, I'm satisfied and duplicate the lamp bits for all the lights. This takes a while since I have to duplicate the light itself, the diffuser, and the little reflective rim. The next big thing I wanted to do was to add colors. While my original intention was to have one of those glam all white kitchens, that didn't seem too fitting anymore. You can see me try out a variety of wall colors, and eventually I settle for a light blue. Then I go ahead and tweak the color of the fridge, giving it a slightly warm yellow for more contrast. As you can see, we've jumped forward in time by a few days. This was my last push to finish everything up. Being an extremely jealous microwave non-owner, I really wanted to add one to this kitchen. The modeling isn't too hard. I start off with a cube, punch it in, then build a door, a technique I've used many times in this series. One slight difference for the microwave is of course having the controls on one side. For this purpose, I shrink the door down to one side, tweak the little window, then build the panel on the right. The right panel is segmented into two parts, the bottom acting as a push button release. I recess its front a little so it looks more like a button. Then I pop in a GIMP and create a new image. We're gonna create a texture map of the control panel and all the buttons. I start off by making a single button, just a rounded rectangle which gets duplicated several times over. Then I add a little green box which will be the digit display. I decide to make the buttons pop a little bit more by mixing a gradient into each button. The effect is subtle, but now the buttons feel like they're a little protruding at the center. I go ahead and add numbers to all the buttons. Finally, I color the two lower buttons red and green, just okay and cancel buttons, I suppose. I make the text a little lighter, round the edges of the texture, and pop back into Blender. I cut up the front and add a panel texture onto the mesh. I had some trouble positioning the texture and end up subdividing the mesh again to get finer control. With that in place, I try around with the positioning of the microwave for a while. Then I move on to the last addition, and that is a little TV for the kitchen. My box modeling techniques are all the same. I hang the TV off the wall at a slight angle, then I pop back into GIMP to set up a nice TV image. For copyright purposes, I decided not to just screenshot some existing software, instead opting to design my own UI. I make some simple buttons using rounded rectangles, adding a nice glow Windows Vista style. I duplicate the buttons several times over and color them differently using the hue tool. I eventually decide against adding text to the buttons, I just couldn't think up of enough names. So back in Blender, I go ahead and apply the texture to the TV. I also decide to add a little stand, just so the TV didn't look like it was floating in mid-air. With all that done, it's time to generate our final renders. And these are the results, the culmination of several weeks of work. I want to take this opportunity to give my thanks to all the texture map providers. Please check in the video description for the original source links. Shoutouts also go to the dev teams of Blender and GIMP for making software that could easily sell for hundreds of dollars, but opting to make their work open source instead. And that's it. That is all there is for this particular season of Speed Model. I hope you enjoyed watching the entire process of creating that room. I certainly had a lot of fun actually planning and creating this entire room from scratch, and I'm glad it turned out the way it turned out. Well, that is pretty much it for this particular season. Thank you once again very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV. Hello, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, remember that I appreciate every like, favorite, and comment you give me. If you'd like to see more from me in the future, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And for more updates outside of YouTube, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at 0612TV. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.